Okay, Google has released Gemini 1.5. And in this video, I'm going to go through some of the changes that they've made between Gemini 1.0 and Gemini 1.5. But more importantly, I'm going to go through and actually show you using the model and show you using this amazing 1 million token context in here. So let's get started. This new version of Gemini is Gemini 1.5. And the biggest difference here is this is a whole new updated model that actually can achieve a lot of the performance of Ultra 1.0 with the Gemini Pro size, etc. So one of the big things with Gemini 1.5 is that they are now actually confirming publicly that this is a mixture of experts architecture here. So many of the rumors around GPT-4 have been that it's a mixture of experts. Of course, we had the Mixtral late last year, which was a mixture of experts model. And now we know publicly that Gemini 1.5 is a mixture of experts model as well. The other big advancement here is a whole new way of doing the context window. So the basic version of Gemini 1.5 Pro comes with 128,000 token context window, so similar to GPT-4, but they also have a version that is actually 1 million tokens for the context window. So that's what I really want to go through here and show you. So if we look at some of the examples of the context windows that are around there, you can see we've got the Gemini Pro, which was originally 32K, GPT-4 Turbo, 128K, Claude 2.1, 200K, and now Gemini 1.5 Pro at 1 million tokens. So this can do an hour of video, 11 hours of audio, 30,000 lines of code or so, and about 700,000 words in here. So it really allows you to basically put in a lot of things in here. So it's also good to see that one of the things that they've done with this context window is actually run some of the tests that open source people have been doing. So Greg Kamrat ran some really cool tests on this idea of a needle in a haystack, of basically, could you find information in a really long context window? And what he found was that for a lot of the models, you just couldn't do that. Now, I think Anthropic showed some ways that they could find some of the things in here. But what Google's claiming here is that you can actually find one of these things in token lengths of up to 1 million tokens here, which is really impressive. So rather than talk about the stats and stuff like that, why don't we actually just jump in and have a play with the model, see what it can do with some video, and see what it can do with some various context lengths in here as well. Okay, so here we've got the Google AI Studio where we can see the model. You can see that I've selected Gemini 1.5 Pro as the model here. And we can upload images, videos, files, a folder full of different files if we want to here. Okay, now I'm basically uploading the combined LangChain docs. Now, if you look at the bottom here, you will see that we've got 1,048,576 tokens that we can use. And you can see that here at the top, we've used 526,000 tokens. So this is basically every page on the LangChain. I think it's just the Python docs that have basically been scraped, saved down as text files, and I've just merged them all together into one big text file in here to make it easier. Now, I'll say that if you upload something as a folder, you can only upload 100 files at a time. So you can have 100 files in here. All right, so we've got this in here. Let's ask it a question. I'm just going to ask it, can you explain what LCEL is and also what LangGraph is, if you can find it? So I'm not sure if there's anything about LangGraph actually in here. Let's find out. When we're doing a inference run like this, we're running inference over 500,000 tokens. It's going to take around about 50 to 60 seconds to go through and actually do this. So it can change a bit depending on what the tokens are. So in this case, all the tokens are text. Actually, it's running much quicker now. But sometimes if the tokens are video, they will take longer and stuff like that. So it does seem like it's found what LCL is. So LangChain Expression Language. LangChain Expression Language is a declarative way to build LangChain chains. It goes through and it tells us a bit about them and stuff. LangGraph, it does seem like it's already found LangGraph as well. LangGraph is still under development and is not yet officially released. So I think it's been officially released. So maybe the version of the docs is a little bit old. Okay, this time let's try and get it to actually write some code using these docs. So I'm going to ask it, write me a simple chain using the chat Google generative AI. with Gemini Pro for the model. All right. Again, because I'm running it on 500,000 context here, it's going to take about 50 seconds to actually do the inference. So I'll just pause it here and come back when it's going. Okay. So you can see just at the 50 second mark, it's kicking in. Okay. From LangChain, a import chat. I'm not sure if that is actually correct there, but it's gotten Gemini Pro, meaning a very old sort of style LangChain with an LLM with a prompt template, and basically running through it. And then it's explaining the code to us in here and basically explaining that this should be the Google API key in there. All right, so let's move on and have a look at some videos now. All right, so many of you have seen this video of the original Gemini demo of basically asking it about a duck, playing a sort of game, finding the paper, playing paper, rock, scissors, doing some comparisons, doing this. So let's check this in and see, okay, how well does this do? Okay, so here you can see I've taken that video, I've put it up here. I'm just going to click this run while I'm doing it. And I've put in a prompt. And so the prompt is basically saying, can you break down each scene in this and give me an outline of the video? So really, we're just looking to identify some of the scenes that were in there and then be able to generate what's going on. Okay, at 0 to 19 seconds, video opens with DeepMind explaining testing capabilities of Gemini. Scene one, drawing a duck. Okay, so that's quite good. The person draws a squiggly line, then guess the country for scene two. And it shows, yes, a map is of the world is drawn. Okay, Gemini asks the user to guess the country based on a series of clues. And it's a bit slow in generating as it goes through this. All right, it's generated the whole thing. Scene three is like a magic trick, performs a magic trick with a coin, hand gestures. So Gemini correctly identifies that the gestures are rock, paper, scissors, and a butterfly. Yarn and imagination for scene five. I think that's correct there. And then it's trying to do some of the reasoning and decision making. And then finally, scene seven, connect the dots. A person completes a connect the dots puzzle. Gemini identifies the puzzle as a picture of a crab. So it's gone through and identified a lot of the things in this video pretty correctly. All right. And this, I haven't staged it. I haven't done any other prompts. I've just uploaded the video and then asked it for this. Overall outline, introduction to Gemini's capabilities, examples of Gemini's ability to reason about images and video in here, conclusion and call to action. All right. So I'm going to accept that in here. What I could do also is I can ask it very specific questions about a video. So let's look at another video and try asking it some very specific questions. So in this example, I'm going to be using quite a famous psychological experiment, the monkey business illusion. There are different versions of this. Basically count the number of times players pass it. And you'll notice that if you've seen this before, the whole thing is, do you actually see this gorilla in the middle here as we go through? So let's come in here. We're going to ask it, how many times do the players in white pass the ball? And I've edited out the answer, so it shouldn't know the answer for this. So let's run this and just see how it can do it. And then we will ask it, the other thing is that if people do notice the actual gorilla in there, they often don't notice that the curtains change colors in here. So it says 15. So I think the correct answer is 16. So that's not that bad. What if I ask it, how many times do the curtains change color, and run that? Okay. So it's going through. So it is kind of amazing that this video is under a minute. The curtains change color once in there. Okay. Let's try one more. What animal walks through the scene in the middle? Okay, let's see if it's able to work out that's a gorilla in there. So I've basically cut out any of the bits that it has got the answers to this. So we've just got the actual thing that it sees. It says a gorilla. Okay, so that's pretty cool that it's been able to go through this video, spot the gorilla, spot the curtain changes, and get pretty close on counting the number of passes that are in there. All right, let's jump on and have a look at one more example. Okay, this time I've basically uploaded a video of Andrew Ng talking about opportunities in AI in 2023. I picked this video just because it's got quite a number of slides in it. So it's really important that we understand that when we upload these things, it's not actually using the audio here. It's just using the video. So while it's tempting to basically get some videos of him as well in here, the challenge is that it doesn't know exactly what it's saying. So it's not actually processing the audio in here. It's just processing the video as we go through this. Okay, so I've got the video uploaded. You can see that it's reasonably long and we're actually using quite a lot of tokens in here. I'm going to get that running. And so the prompt that I'm using here is, please break down this video and make a list of the slides presented with details. This video basically is a presentation that Andrew Ng gave, I guess, about a year ago. And he's got quite detailed slides in here about different things in AI and different opportunities in AI. So I'm really curious to see, okay, how well can it go through and extract the information from the slides and be able to run that? So again, we're coming up to the sort of 50-second mark, and it does seem like for 500,000 tokens, this is roughly where it would start generating at around this kind of point, 50, 60 seconds in. Okay, so this is taking a little bit longer than I thought. We can see slide one, title slide. The slide introduces the presentation and the speaker, Andrew Ng. Slide two, AI is the new electricity. Slide three, technology landscape. Slide four, supervised learning, labeling things. So far, these are looking pretty good for what he's got in here. I'm just looking at the chapters on YouTube for this, and it does seem to be quite consistent that these are the things that he talks about. Example, restaurant reviews and sentiment tracking. Prompting is revolutionizing AI application development. Let's just go through and just accept this so that we can actually read it a bit easier. So it's done a pretty good job in about 2 minutes of going through that 36-minute presentation, working out what the key slides were, and then giving us a little description of each of the slides and that section of it. Now, remember, it doesn't have the audio. What I could probably do is also throw in the transcript of what he said and then get it to use the two of these things combined for that. So maybe I'll do that in a future video for this. Anyway, so just to finish up this video here, this is just a first hands-on with the Gemini 1.5 Pro model. It gives you a taste of what's coming from Google. It's still a little buggy at times. I think the UI is still, they're still working on it and stuff like that. But my guess is that this will be out in the next few weeks for people to get their hands on, to start trying and start using for various different applications. And it's certainly a nice model to have here. And especially when we've got that 1 million token context window, really opens up a whole bunch of new opportunities for things that you can do with this. Anyway, if you've got any comments, put them below. Anything that you would like me to try out on a follow-up video, I'm happy to make a couple of videos of going through Gemini 1.5 with the million tokens. Anything that people want me to try out, put it in the comments below. And I will talk to you in the next video. Bye for now.